I am present.
And your mother?
My mother has found her peace at last. She walks through a world seen only in dreams, and will forevermore.
That is all any of us can hope for.
Indeed. Come.
How was your passage?
Exhilarating. The waves and the wind were with us from the start. We flew like seabirds. And how are you? In spite of your stoic look, there is a brightness in your eyes that warms me.
It may be a kind of hope. Our settlement is growing. The people are happy, and I am looking forward to more.
And your visions?
They come and go. But leave all that aside. Let me help you with your things. This way. We found a fine spot for you at the foot of the hill.
Every hour we traveled, I tried to conjure in my mind some vision of this place.
And how close were you?
I saw the trees, and the water, and the rolling hill. But I could not foresee so much green. It is a magnificent and calming color. A balm for sea-salted eyes.
Valka! Godzebo! What brings you? Hope there isn't a curse on the settlement or some such.
Ha! The only curse on this place is their great lout of a blacksmith. It is a rare feeling to travel across the sea and still find oneself at home. This place feels powerful, alive.
Do you foresee great things for us?
No need for foresight. I feel it.
Valka, I see. What took you so long to follow?
Wanted to ensure the place was... Wanted to ensure the place was up to snuff. We must talk again soon, Randvi, once I'm settled.
And before my arms fall off, what is this I'm carrying?
My heaviest ring. That rainbow, flecks of gold.
Put this one to honest work. That is what I like to see.
All these people you have brought here. This life you have built on these stranger shores. Does it please you?
It does. To know that I've built this place and kept these people safe is a gift.
You speak first of yourself when I ask this question. Which says more than you intend, I think.
Should we be deemed worthy, may we meet again at Ragnarok.
Salve, Eivor. Ad Meliora.
Good day.
And who is that fellow?
I have no idea.
Well, the town must be bustling.
You see there? Your home is just ahead.
Tell me about your visions.
They are as they have always been. Little has changed, save their clarity. With every return, the things I see feel less like dreams and more like memories.
And does the Old Father still appear before you?
From time to time, yes. He speaks to me as well, but it feels mad to say such things aloud.
I understand. You can put those just there, thank you.
And here we are.
Lovely, just as you promised. As soon as I am set up here, we can return to the matter of your visions.
Valka, please.
You are touched, Eivor. A conduit for godly tidings. Please, let me help. I may know a way to clarify these visions. An elixir that may open the door of your mind into the realm of the gods.
If you think it would help, I can finish your home myself. Only give me some time.
I would be grateful. Thank you, Eivor.
Of course. And welcome home. Petra, good day.
Ah, you're back.
A good idea.
Good. A pack of wolves is a foolish thing. This way.
What have you brought for me today, Eivor?
Going around, just up the hill.
You lead. I'll follow.
Our settlement is in quite a nice spot. Beautiful terrain, and the animals here are healthy and populous. But wolves are a worry. It may be why the Ragnarsons moved on. Humans upset the balance of nature, and nature pushed back.
By attacking us.
A wolf will do whatever it takes. They were displaced. Now they come to our door.
Yeah!
Come this way. Look here. Breadcrumbs and crusts. They must have stolen something from Tarbin's stall, or off a table somewhere.
You saw breadcrumbs from where you stood.
They stand out clearly from the soil and grass. See there? Come, this way. Ah, smell that. That's a male wolf, marking his territory, warding off the competition.
How do you know it's a male?
A different odor. You pick it up.
How did you come to be such a skilled tracker?
My family were hunters and trackers. From further east than you've ever seen, I imagine. But I've lived in England for most of my life. This is where we found Wallace.
You two are siblings, as Sigurd and I are siblings. Bound by honor, not blood.
Yes. To hear my mother tell it, we came upon Wallace abandoned. A babe in the woods. We took him in. Look. The wolves made a kill here. They're in the area. Those trails. They must have dragged the poor beast away. We're getting closer. Ah, see those teeth marks on the carcass? They're different.
This is the pack's doing, not just one.
That's right. Let's go on.
So your family found Wallace in the woods?
We were traveling through the forest when I spotted a white elk ahead of us. I chased it, hoping to take it down. I lost it as I came to a clearing. And there on the ground was a wee babe. Our little Wallace, swaddled and alone. Ah, look at that. The pattern on the grass. They slept here.
I'm impressed, Petra. You have a raw skill.
You have seen nothing just yet.
So you saw a white elk, and that led you to Wallace.
That's right. It felt fated. We took him in and nursed him back to health. I was scarcely more than a toddler myself then. And from that day forward, we were raised as brother and sister. These kills are fresh. They're likely near enough to hear us. Probably fled the scene not long ago.
Help! I think we found our wolves.
You there! Get to cover! Eivor, with me. Let's end this.
Your side. That should be all of them.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, both of you.
Are you all right? Were those your sheep?
They were. God take them. They were all I had in the world. Poor blighters never stood a chance. I lost my cows some months back. Now the sheep are gone. Frowning Jesus, what sort of farmer am I?
I'm sorry for your loss. With the wolves gone, you can recover in peace.
Not without the blessings of God, I won't. But I shall try.
You have your life, farmer. With that alone, you can always rebuild.
Eivor, hold. I hear something.
What? What are you? Oh, goodness gracious me! Felix! Rosemary! My beauties! You're alive! Come here, my precious angels!
Well, that worked out. That worked out.
This is grand, Eivor. You hunt almost as well as you fight.
Give me a few weeks, I'll learn to track as well as you. Or better.
I would be happy to be so humbled.
This was a joy, Petra. Do not hesitate to call on me the next time you spot any errant beasts.
You were the first on my list, Eivor. See you soon.
Eivor!
This area is off limits. I shouldn't be seen here. I hope you'd work. Guards here are vigilant.
Finish!
too, brother.
In for the finish! Yeah.
What? Dark spirits torment.
Gentlemen, Repair that.
Thank you. Come here a moment. Give me a hand! Help me out here!
Thank you.
Anything to help you feel at home.
I am most at home helping others. May we return?
We could.
I need one brood. This elixir will help you dive deeper into your visions.
Go, Zulin.
Have the
elixir is ready. It will taste like misery itself, but it will open your mind to the sights and sounds of the nine worlds.
The prophecies of the Nornir are as clear as daylight. The Aesir are doomed. All Asgard, is doomed. Repeat the last passage.
Brothers will fight one another and kill one another. The home of the gods turns red with gore. It will be an age of storms.
The foretelling of a wolf, a great beast.
The wolf Fenrir howls terribly before the gates to hell. The beast will break its bonds and run.
And my part? What about me?
Then comes the second great sorrow. When the Havi goes to fight the wolf. And falls to Fenrir.
And falls to Fenrir. It's there, you see. You have foretold my death. Your Havi will die.
We speak what we see. We know your fate. Your destiny. Have you gleaned enough, O wise one?
Fate governs all humankind, but I am the defier of death. I am not bound by these forces.
All threads are measured. Everything dies. Even ancient Ymir, whose fertile carcass gave birth to the Nine Worlds.
I am no string to be plucked or tied. I am the High One, the Lord of Ecstasy, the enemy of the Wolf. I am eternal. Riddled words only cloud my thoughts. A storm is brewing. Not in the clouds, but down below. Our Ragnarok begins.